Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's Zyblo here, and in today's video I'm gonna be showing you guys how to cast, quick cast, and bind your buttons in Deadlock, especially if you're trying to bind actives to all one button and just spam a button so that you can press literally one button to do everything. This is pretty overpowered. It will literally put you above the rest of your composition instantaneously. But I mean, it is in the game, so I mean, I don't think it's necessarily cheating, but at the same time, it literally feels like it, you know what I'm saying? Only reason why I say it's not necessarily cheating is because everyone can do it, literally. Because, like I said, it's in the game. I think it's stupid because I don't like having it to where, you know, there's really no skill involved in doing it. But anyways, obviously, I'm not going to put myself at a disadvantage. So just to show you guys how to do it, I was watching Average Jonas's video. He was doing like a beat bop one-shot build or whatever the hell. But he was doing crazy stuff and he was literally spamming one button. He was doing all his actives and his E at the same time, or his second ability at the same time, pretty instant. And as you can see right now, I have it to where I'm not gonna do that. So like, if you see how it looks like right now, like let's just say I was dormantly doing it. As you can see, I'm doing it super slow. I don't even think I did it correctly. But it's just because it's so hard to do your actives all at once while you're trying to do your abilities, you know what I'm saying? So specifically for Bebop, this was the command that Average Jonas posted. It's right here, this one. So he says all you have to do is just press F7, which opens the game console, right? And then you copy and paste it. That's literally what he says in his video, in his description. But when you do this and you try doing it instantly right now, it doesn't like seem to work. You see, like it's not doing what he was doing in his video, like instantly. You see, I have to still press it. So the way that you fix that, it's literally super simple. I was literally beating my head over it because I didn't understand how he did it, you know. All you have to do is just unbind whatever commands you put. So I'll explain how his commands, like how to read his commands and how they work so that you can make your own. But now whenever I press my E, which is the button I used to do this, or the same button that he used, now it's gonna do everything all at once instantaneously. No effort whatsoever. It's gonna pop all my actives instantly and it's gonna do my sticky bomb. So look, literally instant compared to the way that I was doing it before. This is just crazy, bro. Literally anyone can do it, and look how fast that is. Like, imagine you compared to somebody that's playing the game normally. Like, this is just insane, you know what I'm saying? So this is what he was doing in his video. He was literally doing this build where he was just phantom striking people and then putting two bombs on them instantly and just, you know, one-shotting them. So the way that it works basically, so you already saw basically how to do it. All you have to do is literally just unbind your keys after you put in the command. But if you want to learn how to do your own stuff so that it's not just a Bebop build, you know what I'm saying, so you could do it for your other characters, this is the way that you read it. So if you see right here, his command says, basically, when he binds E, right, he uses his third item. So in this case, the third item would be Phantom Strike, which is why Phantom Strike is here. Okay. And then he uses, and then the next thing that pops is item one after item three. So whatever is in the item one slot or the active one slot, that would be hit next. And then the next thing is his ability. So as you can see, this is different. So it says ability two. So, you know, you have to keep that in mind for when you're trying to make your own stuff. If you want to do abilities and actives at the same time, you're going to have those ability commands in your code or whatever you want to call it. So ability two is the sticky bomb. So this would be ability one, two, three, four. So that's how you would type in the coding if you're trying to make your own stuff. And then his code is saying after he pops ability two, he's popping ability or item four, which is the active four, which is the reason you'll notice in his video he pops Echo Shard right after four, or right after he pops his ability. Because basically what he's saying is he's gonna pop Phantom Strike first, since it's in the item three slot. He's gonna pop Unstoppable next, which is in the item one slot. Then he's gonna pop ability two, which is his sticky bomb, and then he's gonna pop Echo Shard so that he can get his sticky bomb again and pop sticky bomb right after, which will result in him going in and putting two bombs like that, you know what I'm saying? So that's how you read this basically. Like I said, this is saying he's pressing E to do item 3 first, then item 1, then ability 2, then item 4, then ability 2 again, and then item 2, which is the last item slot that you notice right here. So like popping unstoppable just, or popping curse just for extra like damage and stuff or and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? So that's pretty much how it works. And then if you want to unbind it, like let's just say you mess up or anything and you don't want it on that button, all you have to do is just press unbind and then press the button that you use. So unbind E. So now whenever I press my E, I'm not doing it. So as you can see, I'm spamming E and it's not working anymore. And then you just, like, let's just say you want to go play back to normal, you just rebind it. Literally that simple. And that's it. And now whenever I press 1, it's working like normal. Like, it's only pressing my unstoppable. That's literally the way that you do it. So pretty much any code that you put in, you have to unbind whatever you do. So, like, let's just say you want something simple. I would do a notepad, by the way, so that you can practice, you know, making your own stuff. And I'll show you how to do something, like, really quick. But this is basically, like, I'm going to post these commands in the description below, the ones that I've created so far for myself, because, like, I don't really play Bebop. I play other characters. So this one will do all your actives at once. So, like, let's just say you want to do all your actives only. This would be the command that's for you, like, if you want to quick cast all your actives. You would just copy and paste that code that I have. I usually use 1 for my actives, but if you use a different button, then you would just replace this with whatever button that is. So like, let's just say you use 2, for example, because that's more comfortable to you. Or you use caps. I don't know how caps would work, actually. I've never even tried that, but any button pretty much on the keyboard that you can easily press, that it shows, pretty easy. So if you can find the code for like caps and all that stuff, then you would put that in. But I use 1, so now I'll just enter that. And then you'll know that you did it correctly when it shows this. And now all I have to do is just unbind my actives. So I'm unbinding it. And for me, I like using Wraith specifically, so I'm going to show you like on Wraith. So if you notice on Wraith, she's obviously really good. She can literally stun someone. And if I use like, I like using Unstoppable, Curse, Silencer if I could get it, and Vampiric Burst. So my command that I made, and this is the one that I made based off of literally just learning how to read this. This is basically saying whenever I press 1, I'm using item 1, item 2, item 3, and then item 4. So I made it really simple so that you can like put in order what you want, you know. So like basically my code is saying that I'm going to use this first, this second, this third, this first. So then you'll just change it up. So I'll probably want Vampiric Burst to be first because I want to instantly use my fire rate and lifesteal. And then I'll put Unstoppable so that I don't get stunned or anything. And then I'll put a curse on someone so that they can't do anything. And then I'll put Silencer like after, just that, like if people are trying to run away from me, I'll just do this to silence them and like make them unable to, you know, use certain things, you know what I'm saying? So like if you notice, whenever I press 1, it's gonna do all that together. So I just literally pressed 1 button and it did everything all at once, which is stupid because of how overpowered that is. You're literally using 4 actives at the same time. So what I do usually with Wraith, for example, is I'll stun people, I'll press my F, I'll press my 1, and then I'll shoot them, and then they're dead. GG's. It's pretty easy, you know what I'm saying? And this is, if you want to use all your actives, you can literally make, like, let's just say you only want the first 2 actives to be 1 button, and then you want these as, like, some flex options so that you're not spamming them all at once and you're using them at certain times. Like for example, an ability that's useful for that is, what's that ability? It's called like Phantom Shadow Weave. So like, let's just say you wanted Shadow Weave, for example. So I'm gonna sell this Unstoppable just to show you. But let's just say you wanted Shadow Weave, right? And you wanted to bind this because you don't want it to make you Shadow Weaved every single time. Because it's stupid, because every time you do this, you're basically like not using the ability. Because the ability, the whole point of using it is to become stealth so that you can move around and be stealth and then get behind people, you know what I'm saying? So just to show you quickly how this works to make your own commands, all you got to do is, so like I would copy and paste this one, copy, and then let me put it right here, and paste. And then as you can see right now, I have it bind one, makes it to where item one is used. I would just delete this one because item two is where I have the Shadow Weave right now, if you noticed. So I'm going to delete this one. And now, whenever I put this, now when I put this command in, it should only make it to where bind one uses item one, item three, and item four only. So that I can have my item two slot and use it whenever I actually need to use it. You know what I'm saying? Instead of it spamming just everything. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna copy this now. Copy. And then I'm gonna go over here. F7. And then I'm gonna make sure to unbind my button first. So make sure to unbind the button just so that nothing messes up. Unbind one, because that's what I have it at. So now if I press one just to test it out, if I press one, it's not pressing my buttons anymore. As you can see, you can kind of hear it. But now all I have to do is press F7, type in what I put. So now it should only use item one, three, and four. I put it in. And now whenever I press one, it's only using item one, two, three, and item one, three, and four. You see that? So it's not using the Shadow Weave. And now I can go to the settings, go to hotkeys. And then for item two, which is my Shadow Weave right now, I just press two because I usually use two for it. And now whenever I want to actually use my Shadow Weave, instead of it spamming all together, I just press two. And then now I have it. I'm invisible for a little. I'm waiting to stalk an enemy. I go on them. I press my F. I press all my actives. And then now they're dead. You know what I'm saying? They're dead. So, you know, you can change things up that easily if you're trying to have more control with your stuff. You just have to know how to read. You just have to understand and know how to read these, I guess, commands. But once you do figure it out and learn it, it's literally super easy. You can make your own builds. Like, I literally made this on the spot with Kelvin. I don't think it's, like, that good, but I just put it there. I don't really even use Kelvin. I just made this because I was trying to, like, just make up stuff, you know what I'm saying? But if you want something simple to make all your actives all one button, this would be the command. Like I said, I'll leave it in the description below. If you want this, this is the command that Average Jonas built, so you can find it on his channel. Because I don't want to just post it, because it's not mine technically, it's his, you know. So, but if you want to just copy and paste it, just go to his channel, and you should find, you should be able to find his video where he has this command for Bebop specifically. And then, like, if you want to do stuff with, like, Yamato and stuff, all you got to do is just change the ability right here to whatever the ability is. So, like, for example, right now it's on ability 2. So, like, let's just say you wanted to use a character like Yamato, for example. Let's just say. Or not. Yeah, like Yamato. And let's just say you wanted to make it to where, like, you pop F at the same time as all your actives, right? This is ability 3, keep in mind. So all you got to do is just go to the command thing that I, like, I keep it all in a notepad right here just to make it easy. But you just have to switch ability 2 right here to 3. And then right here also to 3. And then you would type that. And then now this is reading that I'm going to use item 3 first, whatever's in my item 3 slot or my active 3, my active 1 slot. And then it's going to pop ability 3, which is Yamato slash right after instantaneously on somebody. So, like, if I have Phantom Strike, like, imagine if I had Phantom Strike, for example, and then I had Curse, and then I popped my 3 instantly, then, you know, I'm doing a lot of damage to somebody instantaneously. But that's just an example of, like, what you can do and how it works, okay? There's a lot of other stuff you can do with the Dev Console. Make sure not to press Unbind All, because if you do, you will glitch your game where it won't, like, let you move, you know? And it's, like, literally the most annoying thing ever. I had to literally uninstall the game and re-download it and delete all the save files and stuff like that in order for it to refresh and work again. So keep that in mind. Do not press Unbind All. If you do, you're going to have to reset the whole game and delete the files and learn how to do that. But I'm not going to show you in this video. But just be careful with that. Also, I had problems where, like, if I input the code incorrectly, like, let's just say I put this in but I mess up one of these, like, little codes on accident, you have to be careful with that, because one time I had it to where it wasn't letting me shoot with my regular mouse one button or left click. It wasn't letting me left click, and I tried unbinding it right here, like unbinding it and then binding it again, and it wasn't working still. So I had had problems like that. And when you do have problems like that, the only way that I've seen to fix it or learn to fix it is uninstalling the game and deleting the save files. So if you ever have problems or if you mess up anything, just uninstall the game, delete the save files. But you shouldn't have a problem. I mean, it's really simple as long as you just don't mess up any of the little codes, I guess. And that's pretty much it. So if this video did help you out, please leave a like and subscribe. I'm trying to grow this channel, and I'm hoping to grow it with this game, to be honest, because I've been having so much fun with this game. It's really easy to switch everything back. Like I said, all you have to do is go to settings, hotkeys, rebind everything, and then unbind whatever you did. I'm going to do that right now because I want to refresh it. So unbind, I had it on, what, like one? Unbind one. And then now, whenever I use an active, it'll be just regular. And it will just work like regular, you know? So it's pretty cool. So yeah, hopefully this video helped you guys out, like I said. Alright, peace.